project here at the Homeless Project, the Grove Organic Flowers for Arrangement, was begun just recently. We're a very small homeless piece of land directly across the Cambridge building. We've been used to grow exclusively wildflowers for the arrangement. This has provided a safe place for homeless women to live in the daytime. It's provided work for them. And has provided a wonderful new business in the community of San Cruz that is both ethical, moral, and practical. It's in this garden that many women find a place to turn their lives around. While working in land and turning the soil, weeding the beds, planting, watering, provide the kinds of activities that are very nurturing, healing, and sustaining for these homeless women. These are the flowers that are specifically designed to be long-lasting in the global case of the women feel. Imagine this little piece of land with its weeds and junk and garbage and was a beautiful castle a little while ago, and this one has completely transformed this little piece of land into a beautiful garden that graces the community and provides meaningful work for homeless women. The Homeless Garden Project itself gives what's the middle road as far as funding goes. One third of the funding for the Homeless Garden Project comes from government grants and the like, one third from private donations, and one third of the income is self-generated through sales of both the flower arrangements here, through the Women's Organic Flower Enterprise, and through sales of organic fruits and vegetables, which are produced on the gardens throughout our community. All the flowers grown here are organic. That means that no chemical pesticides or chemical fertilizers have been used. And just as fruits and vegetables grown organic are most delicious, the flowers grown here are some of the most beautiful and colorful. This site has typically been a grass-clad area for homeless people in the past, and that the area between World Street and the beach was called the jungle in previous years. Speaking as a former resident of it,
thank you.
we learned again for our entire center. One day, I think we helped candle. And we hear Phil, who was the dog of the candle. Come on, now you like these guys for the whole thing? Well, you know, that's all we need to do. But I think it's the most important thing. Oh, you think you're right. And where do you get your research from? Well, the research from a lot of people in this area, because they have been, you know, he is direct for like, it's like, he's not from the area, so they can never really get an analytics to launch it, like, over there. How many candles did you like to make in this season? So what are you doing here with the I guess Thanks a lot. I'm going to go to the hospital.